Hi there guys, Ken here, your Thrifty Apprentice, and today we are going to be taking a look at Caran D'Ache Supracolor Soft Pencils. They come in this beautiful red tin that is actually very sturdy. They have a very nice artwork on the front here, and it says Caran D'Ache, Swiss made artist grade. These are professional grade of pencil. 30 Supracolor Soft, top quality water-soluble colored pencils. So they do not actually list this on the packaging as a watercolor pencil. They list it as a colored pencil that is water-soluble, which I guess is just a twist of words, but I'm believing meaning more so that they can be used as colored pencils even without adding water, which I think you can use any watercolor pencils that way. So let's look at the back of the packaging here. We have the logo again, Caran D'Ache, Swiss made. Distinctive characteristics of the Supracolor pencils: soft, water-soluble lids produced with a high concentration of the finest pigments. Top quality cedar wood, excellent light fastness, an assortment of 120 colors, all available separately. And I have 30 of them here, so that means I have less than 100 to collect, because I do plan on collecting the entire 120 pencil range. Since I've already started with the 30-piece set, more than likely I'm going to be buying them open stock, because as it says here, they are available separately. So you can buy them a pencil at a time. So I'll probably buy a few here and there at a time until I get the whole 120 collection. The only other information that is copywritten by Caran D'Ache, and that the pencils are produced in France. This is a Swiss-made product. So let's take a look at the pencils themselves. As I said, the tin is really nice. We'll just pop it open here. The logo on the inside. And here you have 30 very nice, very sturdy pencils. Let's take a look at the barrels. Each barrel is color coded. It's cedar wood, which has encased wax base pigment, or pigment mix, or bound together by wax. The barrels have the brand name, Supracolor Soft. It actually says Supracolor 2 Soft. Not sure why. The company logo again, and then I do believe that this is the number for the set. The other information listed on the pencil is the SKU number for buying them separately. The color name, this particular one is pale yellow, the color number, and then the light fast star rating, which we'll get to that in just a moment. Each pencil does have a 2, 4, 6, 8 side. They are 8-sided hexagonal pencils. That is to help keep them from rolling away from you while you work with them. And I'll be honest, I've had other pencils shaped like this that do tend to roll away, but these don't run. I'm not sure why that is. And the wood actually smells really good. Yes, I smelled the pencil, but you know, a little weird, I know, but it smells really good. It smells just like cedar wood. So that is a really good look at the pencil barrels themselves. They come in this little removable plastic tray, which you can take out of the tin. Now, I was thinking when I first saw this is that if you decided you want to store the pencils somewhere else, well, first of all, you could take the tray out and just store the pencils in the tin if that's what you wanted to do. I'm personally going to leave them in the tray just so they'll have the little dividers. But if you decided to store the pencils somewhere else, this tin would make a perfect palette for half pans and full pans of watercolor paint. I just thought I'd throw that out there. Not that you would buy this set just for that purpose, because any tin, any pencil tin would probably make a great palette like that. So that's a look at the packaging and the pencils themselves. Let's take a look at the swatches that I did. So here's the swatch sheet for each pencil. There's a very nice color range of pencils here. The colors are vibrant and bright and pretty. They're really saturated for a pencil. There was not a big color shift between putting the or dispersing the pigment with water wet and then it drying, the colors really did kind of stick. They kind of kept their luster. So I was really happy about that. So the first thing that I noticed was that the color barrels for the pencils actually match really, really closely to the swatches. So I was happy about that. I was impressed because it makes it easy to identify what color you're working with if you don't necessarily, for some reason, you've scratched off the name on the pencil or what have you. It's just really identifiable by looking at the color barrel. So I thought that was something that I would mention that you may want to know. They have a really nice transparency to them. Now, be that as it may, of course, the lighter colors and the more pale colors are going to be a little bit more opaque, but for the most part, overall, the set is pretty transparent. Let's take a look at a few things here as we talk. Now, the very first just little sketch and doodad that I did with the pencils was this little landscape, and it was like back in February, earlier this year. And I was just trying to get a feel for the pencils right off the first time using them. I wasn't trying to do anything too complex or complicated. It's just a little landscape. The pencils laid down and dispersed really smoothly. The pigment doesn't like grit up. They really will disperse and cause for a really smooth watercolor effect. I really love that about these pencils. The drying texture is actually really velvety. And that's even on like, I think this is probably like Artist Loft 90-pound paper, if I'm not mistaken. And they performed really well on that paper. And I'm not the biggest fan of it. The black pencil here was pretty opaque. You know, I really love it. Even once it was dispersed with water, it still maintained its opaqueness. And watered down, it made a really nice gray, although there is a gray already included in the set. So, and we're going to get to those colors in just a moment. So that was like the first thing that I did, and just to get a good general impression. And one of the great things that I loved is that I was able to look at my swatch sheet and just reach and grab the color out of the tin without really checking the name on the barrel. Because again, the swatches and the color on the barrel matched so closely. So again, for the most part, they were transparent. They mixed pretty well here. And it gave me a general idea of how they may layer. So next, I kind of wanted to check to see how they would do with layering and or glazing. So I did a cityscape, and this was actually a tutorial that went up on the channel. If you guys are interested, I'll put the link for it in the video description. You can go watch it if you want. If not, then no biggie. I promise I won't hold it against you. But this cityscape was done with the Caran D'Ache pencils, and it was probably like my second shot out the gate with them, just seeing how they perform. Now, again, I really love these pencils, especially for creating backgrounds. They actually go, they're just so smooth, and it looks like watercolor. And this is another one that was done back in February. As you can see here, I layered down some, I think it was like a burnt sienna, and I actually put it on pretty thick, and then I layered the black on top of that again, which lets you see just how opaque that black color is. The other colors are very saturated. Look how rich and vibrant that yellow is. And you can distinctively see the orange in the transition from the yellow to the orange to the burnt sienna that was put at the top. So the colors work really well together, even on the most economical paper. So I was really happy about that. So they're going to lend well to glazing. They're going to lend well to layering. I'll let you guys take a look at another little quick painting that I did here. Now, this was a painting of some forget-me-nots. It's funny, I almost forgot it. It's some forget-me-nots that I did in my art journal. And I actually ended up using this reference, as a reference, should I say, for a painting that I'm going to show you guys in a moment. But here, I was just trying to take three colors that I don't typically use and kind of use just those four colors, limiting myself to that palette to do a painting. And I think it turned out really well. I love the fact that you're able to blend these colors and they'll mix cleanly, which is what we're moving into talking about now. These colors actually mix really, really cleanly. They don't muddy up. And that's kind of surprising because pencils do have that wax in it. And that's sort of a filler, or sort of like what you would think of as a filler in a watercolor. So I was actually really surprised with the fact that they mixed so cleanly and vibrantly and beautifully, or they stood alone independently the same way. So I used the grass green orange and the blue jeans, which is one of the paler colors we're going to look at in just a second. The color choice and the color selection in the 10, it's pretty good. I mean, you have your regular brights, you have a opaque black. Now, the white itself is not all that opaque. It's actually here. I just wrote the wording in the next square, but it's actually here. And as you can see, I don't know if you guys can see that, but you really cannot see much of a color difference. So I think that that white is more so just for like pulling out your mid-tone highlights. But the black itself is going to be opaque, and it's going to give you a lot of definition. The brights are in the set are pretty bright. Now you do have, some pretty pastel-y light colors here, your rose, your blue jeans, your jade green. And then there's this color called bluish pale, which are really, really more of your pale colors. You have a pale yellow here. Now, here on the swatch sheet, you'll see that I actually have a swatch of dark ultramarine. And this is actually from the Museum Aquarelle set. And I was sent this as a sample in a sample package by the Caran D'Ache company. And I just wanted to swatch it on this because it's the only one of those pencils I have because they are expensive. And I just wanted to swatch it here, mainly so that I can compare it against the ultramarine that came in the super color set. And as you can see, they're pretty comparable. They are definitely, no doubt, the same pigment was used to make those two pencils. And I'm not sure what the extreme difference between the Museum Aquarelle line versus the Supracolor line is. And one day when I grow up and start making a whole lot of money, I'm going to actually buy myself that collection of water-soluble pencils as well. We'll cross that bridge somewhere in the near future in 1,500 years when I get that set. So anyway, that brings me to the light fastness of the pencils. Now, you don't typically get pigment information when it comes to water-soluble watercolor pencils, but you do get light fast information on those more professional artistry grade pencils. I know Caran D'Ache does it. I think Faber-Castell may do it on their Abrador line. I know Arteza does it on their Expert line of watercolor pencils, which I hopefully we'll be obtaining one day as well. But anyway, so real quickly, I just wanted you guys to see, this is a color mixing chart that I did, limiting myself to scarlet, spruce green, yellow, and umber. Just those four colors from the set in order to paint this painting of forget-me-nots, which was inspired by the one that I originally did in a journal. And this was the very last tutorial to go up on the channel. If you watch that video, which I will link that one in the video description as well, you will get a chance to see that the colors did they perform exactly like I say they do. I love the fact that you can take those pigments, scribble it on a little scratch piece of watercolor paper, and then take your juicy brush and make a wash out of that pigment, and you can just layer and layer and layer. Here the darker color was made from mixing black and the scarlet color because it was what was used in the flowers. Now, I could have used ultramarine and burnt sienna as a mixture because that's typically what I use to make my dark for shadow. However, I had not used either one of those colors in the composition. And I knew it was kind of risky introducing black, but I mixed it with a lot of that scarlet pigment before I put it down. And then after it dried, I layered again with a wash of scarlet on top of all of that. So together, it all just blended into what I think is a nice composition. So, you know, For what it's worth, the paints hit all of the check marks. You would not believe, from transparency for the most part to layering, being able to glaze. As you can see here, I did a lift test. The pigments will actually lift out of paper really well. And this is Canson. Yes, this is Canson XL paper that this swatch sheet is done on. So it actually lifted, I was able to lift the color out of some of those swatches, the reds and the purple tones, of course, we know being the most staining colors. And they lifted really, really well. So you have great lifting ability. The colors, great mixtures and clean mixing colors. So they hit all of those check marks in everything that you would expect in a color pencil. Now let's hit on light fastness real quick. The pencils do come with light fast ratings on it. The light fast ratings go from a 1 to a 3 star. I do believe in this particular, on this particular scale, 1 being the most fugitive or the most weak or the quickest to fade, and 3 being the most permanent and light fast. Now, what did I do with the swatch sheet? Of the pencils that came in the set, the majority of the pencils are a 2 star, which puts them directly in the middle. Of the set, you have the rose, which is 1, and the bluish pale, which is 2, that are, I'm sorry, and the periwinkle blue. So 3 of them have a 1 star rating, meaning that they're fugitives, but you would expect those. You would kind of expect that from the more pastel colors. Of course, your core colors like your black, your white, have 3 star permanent ratings, your lemon yellow. Surprisingly enough, ultramarine blue only has 2 stars, but it's still in the middle. And I love the fact that you get some nice earth tones that have some pretty good light fast ratings, especially with me being a flower and a landscape artist. That's really good for me. So yeah, light fastness is included, and for what it's worth, they are pretty permanent. Now the thing is, I really wouldn't expect anything different. I would expect these pencils to perform really well, especially due to the reputation that Caran D'Ache has. So now, for all of the great things and the great qualities that I would say about these pencils, the one major drawback that I have to mention is the price. Caran D'Ache is not the most economical or affordable brand. However, there comes a time, if you're shopping at the right place, because I am the Thrifty Apprentice, that you can source and you can find this pencil set or buy them open stock very, very affordably. For instance, Jerry Autorama always sells them open stock. And I think that there are so many times of the year where they're running different types of door specials and online specials where you can get them at a discount. You can find coupons for Jerry's to use to get them at a discount. Like I said, you can buy them open stock or you can buy them in a set. And it's probably cheaper to buy them open stock a few at a time, especially if you're not really sure about the pencils and you really don't want to invest in a large set right off. Because a 30 color set is a pretty large investment. You can buy a few pencils, you know, buy them open stock, buy your primary colors, buy the colors that you typically use as far as watercolor painting is concerned, and try those colors out first before you decide to invest in a full set or buy more to make your own set over a period of time. So, you know, just getting down to the nitty gritty, I got my set from Michaels. At Michaels, this set is originally priced at $84 for the 30 pencil set. Now, I know all of my viewers who are used to the type of products that I review are probably going, what in the, did you just say $84? Yes, they are priced $84 at Michaels. But the wonderful thing about that is that if you have the Michaels app and you've signed up for their rewards program, there are certain times of the year, like on your birthday, around holidays, or if they're really trying to drive sales, that they will send out coupons to you, and those coupons will be for 50% and 60% off the regular price of an item. So it's definitely my suggestion that if you're buying them from Michaels, to go ahead and sign up for the rewards program. You know, use the points on it for a few months. You'll eventually end up getting that $50-$60 coupon, and I have a 50-60% coupon, and I use the 60% coupon on mine, which actually gave me a discount of $50.40 off of the $84, which made my set around 33 bucks, which actually was not bad considering when you think about 33 bucks versus $84 plus tax. So in that way, they were a really thrifty buy for me considering the brand, what I knew I was getting, how the pencils perform. They do break down to being cheaper if you buy them in a set starting right off, I think. So, you know, look for those coupons. I know that you can source some other places. I'm only familiar with finding them on Jerry's and finding them at Michael's. Now, they are on Amazon as well, but everything on Amazon seems to be completely ridiculously priced right now. I do not understand why, but literally there has been a price jump in everything. And yes, that may sound like a rant, but I'm really kind of protesting that, especially at this time with what's going on. It just doesn't seem right. Maybe I'm the only person that noticed that, but no, I'm not, because I got a comment on another video where I happened to mention that, where someone else said that they've noticed that the prices on Amazon has spiked a bit as well. And I think that's kind of sad right now, considering the fact of how much money I will spend with Amazon. But be that as it may, guys, you can source the pencils really economically. My suggestion is, if you're going to get them, go ahead and get them from Michael's. Sign up for that coupon. I mean, sign up for their rewards program. Wait to get that 50 or 60% coupon. Either one of them is going to be great, and it'll bring the pencils down to a really economical price. If you don't want to wait till then, my suggestion is to go to Jerry's. Autorama.com, and you can buy the pencils open stock there. You can buy them one at a time, get you a couple of colors, and then just go from there. So guys, there you have it. That is the review of the Caran D'Ache Supracolor Soft pencils. Hopefully you found this information useful. You found something that will help lend to you making a decision whether these are something you want to eventually add to your art collection. Yes, they are an investment, but I promise you they are worth them. And with as thrifty as I am, I would not be recommending them if I did not think that you could get them at a much cheaper price than they are listed retail, and that you will not regret making the purchase. Treat yourself, especially if you're a watercolor pencil freak. So if you like the things you heard, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up. Go ahead and subscribe so you can keep up with all of the new content coming up on the channel. I have a lot of great things planned. Great things. Use the comment section. I would love to hear from you guys. And please share the video. And as I tell you at the end of every single video, just keep painting.